So 2020 is almost over, or maybe it is over by the time you're watching this. And I know that many people are going to say what they accomplished this year. They're going to upload their year in review videos, including myself. I'm going to upload this video later this week. But I know that there are going to be so many people showcasing the highlights of their year without telling you that there have been moments when they hated 2020. Because let's face it, 2020 was painful. It sucked. It was terrible in more ways than one. And I don't want to contribute to this false image of just showing you everything that I accomplished or everything that I did well this year and not telling you about the dark sides or not telling you how disappointed I was in 2020. So if you're struggling this year, and if you're reviewing your year and you're feeling like 2020 has been an utter disappointment, watch this video. Hi, I'm Laura. Welcome back to my channel. I make new videos twice a week and I talk about lifestyle design, minimalism, veganism, traveling, and learning. So if you like these topics, make sure to subscribe to my channel and click the bell icon so that you're notified whenever I make a new video. You can also follow me on Instagram if you want to see more of my daily life. You can become a patron of this channel if you'd like to support us. Thank you so much to all of my patrons for supporting our channel. And you can like this video and leave a comment later if you want to support us too. That helps us so, so much. And like I said at the beginning of this video, I know that this time of year between Christmas and New Year, and then later at the beginning of the new year, there is a flood of videos telling you about the New Year's resolutions, planning for 2021, and reviewing the old year. And that is all great. I love these videos. I watch these videos, I make these videos, and I'm going to continue making these videos. But I felt like 2020 deserves a different video because it was a very different year. And what inspired me to make this video is my own experience. When I was reviewing 2020 a few days ago, I felt horrible. Even though there were so many things that went well, even though I accomplished so much, I felt like crap. I felt so disappointed in 2020, in myself, in my career, everything. And if I felt like that, and I'm kind of a public figure and you follow me and I am a source of inspiration to some of you, I figured that probably you felt like that too at some point during the year, or maybe right now when you're going through your year and you're summing it up. And I want to help you go through this process because it helped me so much to realize that it's okay to feel like that. And I later applied a few steps that I learned in therapy to feel a bit better, because this year was, of course, not my best year, and let's be honest, probably not your best year, but it was still good. But at the same time, you have every single right to feel bad about it. And I hope this video will help you feel better. So there are four things that I want to talk about in this video. And the first one is that you can be upset. You can feel angry, sad, and disappointed about everything that went wrong, everything that you haven't managed to accomplish this year. And I want you to know that it is okay to feel like that. And I'm saying this because so many people are going to be so excited about the new year, 2021, let's do this. And in the middle of all of this, you might be feeling like, why am I not excited? Why am I not happy? Why am I not like feeling anything positive right now? And I want you to know that it is totally normal and okay. Even if nobody else is sharing this on their social media, even if everyone is just excited and saying what they accomplished, I'm here to tell you that I felt like shit after I reviewed my year. I felt disappointed. I felt horrible. I felt like I disappointed myself, and like I disappointed you guys, and like I disappointed everyone, and that this year was nothing like I imagined it to be at the beginning of the year. And it is okay. What helped me so much with that is I watched a video by Katie Morton. She's a therapist, and she talked about it too. And the way she talked about it made me feel like I had the right to feel like that. And we have the right to feel disappointed. 2020 was not for us. Nobody prepared us for 2020. Nobody ever taught us how to behave when the whole world shuts down almost. And the fact that we survived it is one thing that I'm going to talk about later, but the fact that we did it and we survived it and we did so many things doesn't mean that we didn't want this year to be like that, you know? So if you want to do that and if you can do that, please allow yourself to heal from 2020, because it probably hurt you and it traumatized some of you, and it definitely made me feel bad about my life and about my goals and everything many times during this year. So I did that for myself. I reserved some time to just heal and process all of these emotions. I journaled about it, I talked to my boyfriend about it, and even though it sucked to talk about how disappointed I am and how angry I am, allowing these emotions to come up and just go through me and then feel them and let them go helped me realize that it is okay to feel all of these emotions. It doesn't mean anything bad about you. It doesn't mean that you didn't appreciate 2020. Of course not. But we should allow these emotions to come and go, because this year was tough, to say the least. So the first thing that will help you process 2020 is actually allowing yourself to be at whatever state you're at. So if it's an angry place, a sad place, a disappointed place, it's okay to be there for a while before you can get all excited about 2021. The second thing that will help you process 2020 is, please don't expect 2021 to magically erase every single thing that happened in 2020. What I'm seeing on social media right now is people tend to think and portray 2021 as this magical gateway, and we will all walk through this and nothing that happened in 2020 will matter anymore. And that's a very hopeful approach, but at the same time, I don't think it's realistic. And let me explain. I do believe that 2021 will be better. I do believe that we will be happier and that everything will be over at some point. But I'm not thinking about it in a way that I will wake up on January 1st and I will be like, yeah, 2021, let's do this. I'm so excited. Everything will be different. 2020, who? No, I don't think about her. Nothing will happen. I mean, everything will change and nothing will change at the same time. It's just another year. So what I want you to think about is that January and 2021 will not be this magical pill that will help us digest 2020. We can do that, but January isn't magical in itself. We can all create new habits. We can all do many things to improve our lives in 2021, but it's not 2021 that will do that for us, you know? So please, if 2021 is this beautiful magical land that you think will take all your problems away, be real with yourself and just think about 2021 for some time as this extension of 2020. It can get better, definitely, but it's not like it's going to go away the minute we get a new year, you know? So let's all just keep that in mind and not go crazy about 2021 being just creme de la creme. The third thing that I want you to do is be proud of yourself. Everything, even if it's only one thing that you accomplished in 2020, counts times 500. If you graduated college, if you graduated high school, if you changed your job, if you moved to a different country, if you woke up 5 times a week and went to work, even if your work was located in your living room, even if you woke up every single day and ate something and did nothing for the rest of the day, please be proud of yourself. Take out your journal or a piece of paper or write it in your phone. Think about all the things you did in 2020. And be proud of yourself for it. And to every single accomplishment on this list, add during a global pandemic. And hug yourself, be proud of yourself, and give yourself a hug. Hug yourself and tell yourself, hey, I'm so proud of you. You did this during a global pandemic? You're a star. You're my hero. You did it. You did it. I'm so proud of you. I'm so grateful for you. And the reason why it's so important to be proud of yourself and of everything you've done, even if it's only one thing, is that it puts everything into perspective. It shows you that you did so many things during a time that was so tough on us and so horrible for so many of us, and you did it anyway, which makes it huge. And it is so beautiful, and you did it, and I'm proud of you. Even if you're not proud of yourself right now, I am proud of you. I connected to so many of you during this year, so many of you found me, and so many of you messaged me, and so many of you shared what you did this year with me. And I know that it is so, so important for you to recognize that you have so much to be proud of. Everything you did in 2020 deserves a prize and a medal and a promotion and $1 million. So thank yourself for everything you've done and be proud of yourself because you deserve it. You deserve to be kind to yourself and you deserve a prize, a medal, and a promotion and $1 million and a pat on the back and a hug. So after everything you've done to heal from 2020, after you've allowed yourself the time and the space to process all of these emotions, the last thing that I want you to do is to dream big for 2021. I'm saying this because even though I just said that 2021 won't be this magical pill, etc., it will still be a new chance for all of us. So it's not like everything will go away, but we have the power to change things. We have the power to create our own lives, and we have the power to do things and to accomplish things. I want you to dream bigger than ever before, because one day all of this shit that's going on will be over and we'll be all happy again, because we'll be thinking about the pandemic as this past weird memory, and we'll all have so many opportunities again. But you can start creating these opportunities for yourself right now in 2021, and you can dream even bigger than in 2020, because you already know the drill. You already know how to play this game. You already survived 9, 10, or maybe even 11 or 12 months of the pandemic. I am super proud of you, and you should be proud of yourself, and you already know how it works, so you can start preparing for everything you want to accomplish in 2021. And if you need some guidance on that, I have a video on how I planned my 2021. I kept it a bit more realistic this year, but still I have so many goals and dreams and things that I want to accomplish in 2021, and I'm going to show them to you. I'm going to keep you posted, but for now, I just want you to remember to be gentle with yourself. Even though I want you to dream big and I want you to accomplish all of that in 2021, I still want you to remember that this year has its own place in all of our lives and it deserves recognition, and we will all remember 2020. But you can also heal yourself from everything that happened in 2020 so that you don't carry this baggage into 2021. It's like ending one relationship and healing everything that happened before you can start a new one. So I hope this video helped, and I'll link all of the videos that will help you in 2021 and beyond in the description box. And let me know in the comments how you're feeling, if you're feeling better after watching this video, and what you will be doing in 2021 to heal from 2020, or how you are preparing for 2021. I'm so, so curious to know, so please let me know in the comments, and like this video if you enjoyed it. Follow me on Instagram if you want to see more of my daily life. Subscribe if you haven't already, and I'll see you in my next video, and I wish all of you a happy new year, and I hope that 2021 will be easier on all of us. Thank you so much for watching. Bye bye.